The Fifth Kind. In the highlands district of Chichicastenango, a young Dominican friar by the name of Francisco Jimenez has arrived to serve as parish priest. Francisco is a true enthusiast for the Dominican tradition he represents. This means he has a passion for scholarship and the study of ancient books. An avid linguist, Francisco relishes the opportunity to sit down and listen to the stories of his new hosts as he learns the ins and outs of the local language. Francisco's enthusiasm and his respect for his hosts gradually wins him the trust of the local community. They are the successors of the ancient Mayans, whose culture once dominated this country in Guatemala. One day, Francisco is presented with an unfamiliar text, written in the indigenous language of Quiché. The priests of the Feathered Serpent, descendants of an ancient Mayan priesthood, explain to the young Francisco that this ancient Quiché text holds their story of human origins. Somehow, this text has survived the banning, burning, and burying of the 15th century. It is a story which has been told for at least 100 generations, detailing the Mayan succession of kings and explaining how the human race itself came into being. 7 years pass as Francisco navigates the nearly forgotten Quiché language and emerges with a translation into 18th century Spanish. What has emerged through his literary journey is an account of human origins which had been kept hidden for more than 10 generations. Francisco Jimenez's translation becomes known as the People's Book or the Popol Vuh. When the Catholic forces of Portugal and Spain invaded Central and South America, they did what all colonizers do. They took over. They established themselves with a strong military force. They provided the army. They were the army. The rest were insurgents. They provided the police. They provided the education. And they shut down all other authorities within those lands. And that meant extinguishing other religions, extinguishing other priesthoods, and burying, burning, or archiving their books. So it really was an amazing turn up when Francisco Jimenez was handed the Quiché text that told a totally different story of human origins. My book, Escaping from Eden, talks a lot about the Popol Vuh because what emerged in that text was a creation account that was strangely similar to the Genesis story. And when you read them side by side, you realize what you have is a picture of a devastated planet Earth. Some kind of cataclysm has happened. It's now flooded and shrouded in darkness. And then these entities arrive. They orbit the waters and they consider how they can re-nurture life on planet Earth. And it becomes clear that what we're looking at is a planetary reboot. The story that emerges of the creation of human beings is very different from the one with which Christians of that generation were familiar. This was a story of other beings arriving from elsewhere and engineering our ancestors from the animal life that was already here. That was the story that the Catholic authorities wanted to extinguish. And yet it survived. It survived in the unknown Quiché language. And it was Francisco Jimenez who brought it back for posterity. Escaping from Eden argues that this knowledge was there right in the roots of the Judeo-Christian tradition, but that it was suppressed. And you can see this story of suppression beginning within the pages of the Bible itself.
The Ten Commandments famously begin with the commands, "You shall have no other Elohim before me. You must not bow down to them, or even depict them." A great forgetting is being commanded.
The Fifth Kind. Click on the links in the description to watch the full video.